What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some Ark Survival Evolved. Peeps, hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. And you may have seen in the text here, because of the lack of pre-planning on the part of XP and Softus in regards to them not having Trank Darts, I'm about to get a 120th level RG. Yeah, that's right. And the best part is, XP's gonna deliver it. He's gonna bring it to the base right now. So let's go ahead and head down. No, wait, that's right. We changed where our refrigerator is. It's up here. So let's go ahead and grab our RG kibble, because why wouldn't you? We're running a little bit low. We've been that is the wrong place. We've been taming a lot. Stego kibble 7. We'll grab it. We got some stuff and things on our inventory too. In our inventory, I said. So we need to get rid of that. And he should be here in a minute. I wanted to stop before he gets here and take a couple of seconds here just to say, you know what? That farts are funny. And that I appreciate you guys showing all the nice support stuff and things, your likes and nice comments on the channel. I really do appreciate. Wait, I can't. No one can see Thruster. You're not in the spotlight. Slipgator is. Thank you guys so much for your likes and support in the videos. If you guys like this video, no, don't poop. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button if you haven't already. Don't forget to subscribe for more stuff and things, peeps. All right, XB is going to be here. He's going to be here at some point with an RG. We need to go. We need to do some whistle passives here. We got so much stuff and things. We're also going to work on the dino pens today, but I want to get this guy down. Oh, you know what else we can take a look at? I have no idea if my RGs are males or females. I cannot remember. Oh, no, that's right. We only have tonnage. I do remember. I remember things. We only have tonnage as our one dude. And so we're going to, and he's lower level. So we're going to have a 120th level perfect tame dude to be a dude with the ladies. He's going to be like the dude. He's going to be like, who's like a really sexy man? Fabio? No, I think my mom likes Fabio. He was a guy. Who else is a really sexy man? I don't know. Bieber? Some people like Bieber. I'm not a Bieber lever. I don't know if I've ever heard a Justin Bieber song. Right? Maybe. I don't hate Justin Bieber, but I know I'm not in love with him, nor would I want him to sire my children if I was a lady. Where's XB? I'm running out of things to talk about. And we're back. XP is supposed to be here soon. Just making sure we're all on passive. He says, here I come. Where is he? He's not here. I don't see him. Bring him to me! Rain of Fire reference. Oh yeah! Reload that bad boy. I'm going to try not to hit him in the head this time. We were doing that one with the softest the other day, and it got a little hairy. So hopefully this will work out a little bit better. Yeah, come on over here, homie. You want to get knocked out? Oh, he's a good white color, too. Kind of pee on the back, but not that bad of a thing. Oh, come on. Go down, homie. You tired? Oh, he's knocked out. He's knocked out. We did it. Nailed the ACK. We stopped. We didn't even accidentally shoot him. Oh, baby! So we only have 7 kibbles. Let's squirt them on, squirt the kibbles on there. Thanks, XB, very much. We're going to have to get him like a kingly gift. Like some sort of king. Oh, you know what? We could get him? Because I know he doesn't have any. It's Trank Darts. Oh, nice. That's cool, man. He just said he just got a 120 baby as well for those people who are only listening. So we're going to put some meat on this guy. We're going to sit here and tame him up. And, yeah, then I'll be RBs, peeps. And we're back! I got my 50 Trank Darts that I made up for XB. I actually had a couple more already in here, so we'll top off that right there. I got my little storage cube. I got my little sign. We're gonna go ahead and get on Thruster. Actually, yeah, we'll take Thruster over, I guess. It's good to get a fly on him. I was gonna take the double, because we'd get there on the double. Because his name is... Okay, and but yeah, let's head over to XP's and give him his gift. And we're back. I hope XP's not here, because he very well may be. Nope. Doesn't look like he is. Maybe not. Are you here, XB? Let's place it right here in the center. We'll go like one of these. Nailed it. Darts. Squirting them in there. Bam. Sign. 8. Nailed it. Set sign text. We're getting good at this. Nailed it, ace. It can't be stopped. So now he's got some trank darts, and I'll never get another dino from him again. So, that was really nice of him to bring it over, and I really appreciate it. I want to say thank you by giving him a little gift. All right, we got to go back over and see our new tamed guy. We got to think of a name for it. And we're back, and we've got our new RG-179 perfect tame. He ate 6 kibble, so we're down to 1 kibble now, guys, from like 30-something that we had. So, oh, wait, we can't go here anymore. We've got to go up top to drop it off. We've got just the one. I mean, one doesn't really... I mean, one's... It's not really even a mouse on a wheel. But we do have the one. So it's a thing that we have. And we can keep this one. Go like this. Go like this. Go like this. We'll stick it right up there. We still have a bunch of other stuff, though. We've got 5 Parasaur Kibble, 11 Dodo Kibble, 10 Dillo, and 10 Dodo Kibble. 11 Dillo Kibble, 10 Dodo Kibble. But our ladies over here have not been really laying eggs. And I checked just to make sure if somebody played a prank on me. And they're all ladies still. So I was just like, wait. Yep, you're a lady. They're all ladies. But they're just not laying eggs recently. And I don't know exactly what's happening with that. I would love for them to do it. But it doesn't matter. So let's go ahead and talk about the name of the RG. You may have seen it. But I want to explain it to you. We've called them Your Pants. That way we can say I'm on your pants. Or... You know, do you have any of this? Yeah, it's in your pants. We can talk about breeding in your pants or on your pants. It's funny. I like it. So let's look at the statistics. 1,500 health, 2,300 stamina. No one cares. Oxygen food. 530 weight, 42 melee damage, and 100% movement speed. So he has a pretty high melee damage, and he's good to go. Now, Softus said he wanted to breed this bad boy. And I think what we're going to do first, though, is breed it with Ouncey. Because Ouncey was a perfect tame, and so was Your Pants. So, we're going to bring him over to the breeding pen. And we're going to work on this, I think, when we're doing the dino pen. I hope we have time. Now that we've done this RG tame, this is taking up a little bit more time today. And we might have to put off some of the building of the... Well, we'll do some of the building of the dino pens, but it might be like a 2-part episode now or something like that. So, let's go ahead over here and get Ouncey. I'm interested to see how this works out. We're going to go ahead and breed him up and get a baby. And we're back, and I lied. We're going to have more time to do the building today because Ouncey can't breed again for 6 more days. So we still haven't changed the timer for that, I guess. But yeah, so we can't do that. But we got it over there. I'm actually going to let Softus know. Softus wants to breed with it, so we'll let him come over and do that. And we'll just put your pants over here in this place. We'll just put your pants right here, and then he can come over and breed with your pants, and that'll be a thing. All right, so the other day, I had said we were going to do some dino pens, and I said I was going to spend some time off camera getting a bunch of stuff and things done, and I wanted to show you what I have accomplished in this regard. Mostly with thatch, we will be building, and we've got a lot of it, peeps. I only got 10 foundations, but... We got 81 roofs, 61 sloped roofs. I got 11 of the other things, the sloped wall right and left. I got 63 door frames. I built 63 door frames. So I accidentally built 63 door frames, but we could go ahead and build some more foundations and stuff and things like that as well. I think I've got a bunch of thatch. I've got a bunch of everything except we're going to need to have a fiber party. Oh, also, I found a new engram for the pike. I found an apprentice pike engram. And we had been using the regular pike for a long, 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 long time. So this is just your regular 40 durability, 100 weapon damage. And this bad boy, 60 durability, 130% weapon damage. We've got to get it dyed up, a cool color. But all right, so going to build some foundations, going to build some, go get some fiber. And then I think what we're going to do is we're going to start right over in this area with kind of a diagonal type deal where we're going to put some dinos. So, all right, I'll be your beast, peeps. Man, we're back. Softest got all of his guys bred up. I decided we're going to start over here in this area with some thatch foundational stuff and things. And this will be our place with which our dinos that, like, don't lay eggs will go. This is where, well, Dermorphodons can lay eggs, but these ones do not. Oh, also, did I tell you that Bloodwing is now 2,600 health, 1,000 melee damage, and we're probably going to start pumping his movement speed now because he's amazing. And once they come out with the double tap in order to pick people, these guys up and down, which right now it's single tap. But when we have double tap, we will probably start to bring him around with us because I feel like he's powerful enough that he will not die. And we will put our non-egg-laying dinos in this area over here. 2, 3, 4, 5, eating the meat. Now, is this the proper angle for stuff and things to happen? We kind of want to get this right, but it's kind of got to be diagonally. So, it's kind of got to be on a diagonally diagonal. I feel like this is a pretty good diagonally diagonal right here. Maybe a smidge to the right. Smidge to the right. Is that too much? No, I feel pretty good about this. Now, I'm thinking we're going to start like, yeah? I hope this works. We can go further. This is pretty good. So we can't fit another one over there. And then over here, I feel like we're pretty much... Nah, I don't want to be any closer than that. So now we can back up. And I'm going to guess I didn't bring enough to finish. All right, so we can get some more of these bad boys right up over here. And then how many far... I was going to go five across, but I went maybe more than five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 across. So we need, what would that be? Like some more thatch stuff and things? No, those are roofs. These. And then we need some ramps, which I have built as well. That's right. 10 ramps. Sounds good. All right. So let's pop back over here. Like a soup. Oh. Oh, it kind of sticks out a little bit right there. Well, I'm glad that it. Oh, no, no. Why do you hate me, game? Game, why do you hate your Slipgator? Oh, this one can't be a thing? Why do you hate me? Why do you hate me? Oh, that's going to make it so ununiformed. And I want it to be, but now it's going to have to be a ceiling. And then most likely in order to remedy this issue, we'll have to ceiling the entire thing. Because then that way it will be all the same flatness. There we go. 15 of these guys. So, does that mean... I really wanted to use foundations. Hate. What? Okay. So, a little bit of a redesign because of the issue with that. Oh, man. You know what? If I'd have pushed this back just a little bit, it probably would have fit. But I wanted to have a walkway back here in case I wanted to walk over like this. And I think that that's a good walkway to want to have. Perhaps if we were to do this, maybe we don't need the walkway that bad. Let's go up in here. Check this out. We are doing it, peeps. Perhaps if we were to go like this... Ooh, not bad. And then we'll just wreck the front here. Just going to wreck it. This will make it a lot better. This is what building is like in Ark. See? And then we're going to do it again. All right, nailed it. So now we've got our 2x thingy doodle that we wanted. It's fairly large. It's big enough to fit some dinos. And I'm thinking a substantial amount. Now, the moment of truth, the ramp situation. How's this going to work? Pointing away will be best. Oh, my, I can't believe it. I was able to place every single ramp. This is amazing. So amazing. Okay, so now we're going to need a roof. Some sort of a roof. Nah, or roof. Roof is that not even a word. So let's go with me designing the roof
off camera. I'm going to do a little bit of work, and then I'll BRBs, peeps.
And we're back. And this is shaping up quite nicely. I think that this is going to look great once it's made out of metal. And I decided to go with doorways here, but I'm not really sure. Yes! It's going to work, I think. Oh, how I love you sometimes, the building mechanics of Ark, when they can be cheated. So what I've done is, yeah, we just supported these with these door frames, and I love that they're like that because you can just walk through them, and it makes it really open looking, and honestly, for this little thing built from thatch, I think it looks really good. Like, I love building with metal and stuff, which is super fun because it's expensive and therefore rewarding, but I think this looks really good. I like this. So now if we did some sloped bad hombres, can we get a sloped roof here, buddy? Is it possible? Oh, you know what? I don't think it is because there's no support. So we can... Oh, we can do that. So why can't we do this? Why can't we do that? I want to do that. And we're not allowed to. All right. Let's pop up here and maybe see if placing it from the top will be better. Perhaps this will be a thing. Land? Why aren't you landing? Why did you land there? Ouncy? Not smart. Nailed the ace to can't be stopped. All right. Now... Huh, super weird. So I can place them. I can place them backwards. That is, although interesting for a support, not a good support for us here. I really wanted to do the little sloped roof on the front there. But I guess we're just may forgo that. We may not do it just because it looks like it's not gonna happen. Can we do them on the sides? That is so weird. We can do it there. We can do it there. I mean, we can add one here where you never would want one. But we can't add them off the edge. Perhaps if I finagle it. If there's some finagling that happens. Let's try the finagle. Okay, we can do it this way. Why? Why this way but not that way? Why? Makes no sense to me at all. All right, so we tried finagling. It didn't work, in case you didn't notice. So this is going to be it for now. This is just a beginning starter pen type deal. And I love it. I think it's great, because what we can do is now we can take Blue Dolph and squirt him right here. And this is like Blue Dolph's new spot, and it's very organized. And we could take Bayou, and we could squirt him over here like so. We could be like, this is Bayou's new spot, and we'll squirt him right here. And he can't back up. So it's not perfectly placed. It's very hard to, like, kind of walk slowly. I didn't notice this. Kind of got to tap him. All right, so now we got Bayou spot, and he's good to go. I'm thinking that the Dodic and William Shatner, who we never really named. I can't believe we forgot to name him. That's been going on for a while. Wait, that's right. Somebody named him, and somebody put a name suggestion. I thought it was really good, so we're going to do that one. Flintstone. Flintstone, I think, is a really good name for him, so we're going to name him Flintstone. And we're going to keep these guys in a different area because we need to use them quite often. So other dinos that I think would be fitting to put in there would probably be our wolves. I think all the wolves need to go in there. Any eggs? Yes! Yes, an egg! Give it to me, the egg. Oh, we need these so badly right now. So I'll move all the wolves in as well, and then we gotta start thinking about... Oh, no, wait, we got all these guys, too. We gotta get Brawler in there. Oh, you got a level? Are you heavy? Should we pump weight? No, we're gonna pump melee damage more. Oh, wait, another level, Brawler? 960. Can barely move, so we'll drop the egg off, I guess. We got these guys we gotta fit in, too. And these, unfortunately, I forgot to, I think I mentioned this, but yeah, the scorpions can't mate yet. And we have, I think, all females as well. But we have some really high level scorpions. So we got to try to fit those guys. This is going to be a tight fit for all these guys, but I think we can do it. And we're back and I'm very happy. Not because of all the butts, but because of the organization. Something so simple. Has created this amazing organization-itude-ality in which we exist now, and I just think it's the most amazing thing that ever happened right now, and I'm super excited about it, and it was very simple and super fun. All right, so we got a couple things left. Bloodwing and Little Blue. No!
Why do you hate your slip gator? Bludwing and Little Blue need somewhere to live, and we don't have any room for them inside the pen. So I'm going to put them on top. But you can see here. Did you see that move? Pretty much an expert at that move. All right. Let's get up here. Let's go like this. Now we'll jump off here. Now, if we stand way in the back and we throw you, will you land on the roof? Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. Unbelievable. Let's get Bludwing as well. And if we take you and put you on the roof, like so. And they both face to the left. That's interesting. No, this... Oh, this was face... Bludwing faces to the left, and Little Blue faces to the right. It's like they're really doing stuff and things. It is unbelievable. And you can see, I've even gone to the extreme of organizing all of the wolves in order of, well, kind of, whatever, in some sort of order. Beepus, Groupus, Unum, Duo, Tribus. And then we got Brawler and our three... scorpions, and everybody is all lined up, and it's the best thing ever, and I love it. I'm so excited by this, and I like the way that it turned out. It has a look about it, you know? It has the look of the thing where you'd put dinos. So it's perfect, and it's great, and now we've got, that's kind of like the small guys, but what are we going to do with all the big guys? And we're back. Our little pen looks so small from up there. There's so much room here. We're very roomy, but look at it all. All organized. All their butts are out. They're just getting a tan on all. Aw. Beepus just let one loose. They're just all getting their butts all tan. So I was thinking about mobility, slow mobility, and what we could do. And I was thinking about this area over here, and I was thinking to myself, self, this would be a great area for some breeding. Dino pens? Words? And I took all of the rest of the supplies that we had, basically all the stone, and I built this up. So we've got to get this placed really, really accurately. So again, we go into our mode here and see. Oh, you know what? Is it trying to snap to... It's trying to snap to these walls we've got over here, to this little mini breeding area. So we're actually going to have to tear this down so we don't get a snap point. And I'll explain to you why after I'm done tearing this down. And we're back. And I don't think it was actually snapping to those foundations. And I'm a little bit perplexed as to what this is snapping to. But I believe I have it. See, that's snapping there to like nothing. But I believe I have it straight now, which is really the only thing that matters. So, all right, here we go. I'm gonna get this perfectly amazingly straight-ish. I'm going with it. Nailed it, AC, can't be stopped. There's water. We got it. We got it, ladies and gentle peeps. Is it straight? It's pretty amazing. Pretty amazingly straight. All right. So now, are you a pen that is large enough to fit a slow mobility? Going to go right up your butt, maybe. Up your leg butt. All right. Here we are. And then we're going to have to get you all the way in here and see. We probably need to turn you around. Oh, this is going to be fun. And we're back in the air conditioning because it's super hot and I kept taking damage from doing stuff and things. But we have a slow mobility pen now and it's really quite simple. It was really quite easy and I feel like it's really large. It's like larger than a slow mobility. So it's a huge thing. I guess we could put other dinos in here too, but I don't know that we want to. I don't know. I don't know. Now that I look at it, I thought it was just slow mobility size, but it's really huge. I don't want too much of his tail sticking out the back. I think he can take damage that way, to be honest with you. Is your tail in? Probably nothing going to attack him over there. All right, let's try to use the tail method for taking less damage for deboarding the slow mobility. So there's a lot of room over here, so I'm thinking maybe Gator can hang out in this place as well. This probably be a good spot for a Gator to live. He's so cool. All right. What do we want to pump on him? He's got 1,000 melee damage health. 5,000 health. All right. Maybe we'll pump some movement speed on him as well. Can we squirrel through your legs? Oh, wow. Nope. We can't even a little bit. Nope. This is a big... Nope. It's a big problem. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Gators and Brontos don't get along. So we can kind of move him over here like a so.
and like this, and then that'll be his little spot. He'll hang out here with Slow Mobility, and it will be amazing. So, but I'm thinking that we're going to add another pen over here, and we're going to do it again with Gates, because I think we can do one for Hardware and the T-Rexes all in one spot. So, because this is pretty big. So what we've got to do is try to line this up. Now, these are tricky. What I do is I try to line the little outcropping here. You can see how it's like a corner. It looks like I pretty much lined it up, but wait, no, it doesn't. No, that's not good. No. Better? No, that doesn't seem better. This is so difficult.
I think I've got it.
Let's go ahead and take a look. No, that's not taking a look. This is taking a look. Does it look pretty much the straightest ever? Oh no, it's at a weird angle. Oh no, why? Much better. Nailed it, Ace. Can't be stopped. Just eyeballed it, really. Just gave it a little eyeball action. We got to paint these doors too. But I'm thinking this spot, I don't know, do we need to place another one? Like a double? Again? I think we do. And we're back, and look how organized we are, peeps. Oh, you know what we gotta do? Crapo. Ouncey? Yes! Nailed it, Ace, can't be stopped. We've gotta paint the doors over here. But we've got Slow Mobility and the Gator up in this piece. We've got all of our Rexes over here with Hardware in the back there with plenty of room. We've got two feeding troughs ready to rock, and they are full of, well, rotten meat and meat. So we're kicking it there. We're killing it. And then now, just one of these. And then, nailed it, Ace, that can't be stopped. Do we have to do each one individually? Thank goodness, we do not. What region was it again? Two? Oh, yeah. And then we're going to, you know, we'll transfer this or change this all, or, you know, transform it all into metal once it's done. But for nowsies, I mean, I'm pretty excited. There's a lot of room. Wait till I'm done dyeing this and I show you guys this room. Look at all this room. There was all these dinos before, and they were all, like, willy-nilly in and about the area. But now they're all organized inside these just deliciously amazing little pens here. And then there's this one's right here. With this is the pen of butts. And then they're all in here with their butts, and they're just mooning all of us, and it's amazing. This is going to be the thumbnail. The thumbnail is of them mooning us. Oh, man. But cool. All right. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But that's going to be it for today, ladies and gentle peeps. We got a new perfect tame Argentavis dude today, and we did a bunch of organization in and about the place. You know, one of the last things before we go.